What if I told you could reframe 360 photos and videos from any 360 camera completely for free on Mac or PC? You might be thinking, yeah, I'm listening. Well, I've got good news for you. This is what I'm going to show you how to do today, and the software we'll be using is called Insta360 Studio.
Wait a second, Mr. Ben. Don't you already have a tutorial about Insta360 Studio?
I'm glad you brought that up, little man, because today we've received a major update to Insta360 Studio that now allows us to edit 5.7K video from any 360 camera. If you own an Insta360 One X, you'll be able to do more things with this software, things like stabilization and importing without stitching, but for every other camera, it'll work just the same. I'll put a download link to it down there. Now let's get started. So once you've installed the software, locate the file you want to import. I'm going to be importing this INSV file, which is Insta360 One X's format, and drag it onto the left-hand side. If you're shooting with a different 360 camera, it will probably be an MP4 file, and make sure you stitch your footage before you bring it in, because this isn't a stitching software. So straight away we can see our clip, and by default it takes us into view mode. We can't really do much here, so you want to go to the free capture option, and now we have the full ability to edit our 360s however we want. For One X users, flow state stabilization and stitching will be done automatically. At the bottom of the program, you'll find the timeline, and the first thing I want to do is trim this footage, because as you can see, it starts with me setting up the camera, and I don't want that included in my final shot. So I'm going to navigate to the part that I want to start at, and I'm simply going to drag the endpoint to this point. Likewise, at the end, I'll find my endpoint, which is about there, and I'm gonna drag my out point to that point. I thought it'd be fun in this video to try and replicate the opening sequence from my last YouTube video, where I'm jumping around, dancing around like crazy on the tiny plant, looking very, very silly. And I actually did that in about 5 minutes using this software, so I'm gonna show you exactly how I did it. So what we're going to do now is add a keyframe. And for those of you who don't know what a keyframe is, it's essentially a pinpoint where you tell the software, I want everything to look like this at this point in the timeline. So let's go ahead and press the keyframe button, and this is going to set our very first perspective of the video. There are four different options here that show you different perspectives of your 360, but I found consistently the tiny planet option has given me the most amount of flexibility when editing my 360s. You can get basically any kind of edit you want, whereas the other ones are a bit more limiting. So I would suggest, even if you're not planning on doing a tiny planet, selecting the tiny planet viewpoint down the bottom left. And I'm just going to use my mouse wheel to zoom in. I want this to be quite close on me, and I'm just simply dragging the screen to change my perspective. When you're happy, press the space bar to play, and we're going to pause it again at our second perspective. So this is where I want my next keyframe to be, therefore I need to choose an entirely different perspective. Firstly, I'll hit the keyframe button again, and this time I'm going to zoom out all the way into a tiny planet. Now when we play it back, we can see it's nicely transitioned between the two points. Next, let's go forward in our timeline and figure out where our next keyframe is going to be. So here I'm doing a gag where every time I jump up and down, I want the tiny planet perspective to move slightly, just as if the gravity from me hitting the ground moves the tiny planet. To do that, I'm going to go to the exact point that my feet hit the ground, and I'm going to set another keyframe. This is important because even though nothing changed between this keyframe and this keyframe, it's important we tell the software that we want it to remain exactly the same for this distance of time, which is why we need to create a start and end of this viewpoint, which is done by setting these keyframes. All right, I'm going to add another one and change the viewpoint again. Okay, let's take a look. Great, that worked really well. If you ever want to remove a keyframe, you simply just right click and go delete. Likewise, if you want to edit an existing keyframe, just click on it and you can then move the perspective like that. It won't work if you move the image at a random point that doesn't have the keyframe, because you're not telling the software to lock in this viewpoint. So even though I did that, as you can see, there's no keyframe there. So when I press play, it just defaults back to the existing viewpoint. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and add the rest of the keyframes to this video. When you're done adding keyframes, you'll now want to focus on transitions, which are these lines in between the dots on the timeline. To edit a transition, simply click on it, and now we have a few options for how we want this transition to look. There are six presets here, which are essentially pre-recorded movements. Some of them start fast and end slow. Some start slow and end fast. You'll just have to have a play around with them, but these are going to help you make your transitions as smooth as possible, so I would recommend using them. So for this gag here, I want to make it when my feet hit the ground, I want the planet to move quickly and then end slowly and smoothly. So I'm going to choose slip in, fade out. Now when I play it back, it does just that. Now I'm going to apply this transition to my other two jumping bits. But you don't have to make a silly tiny planet animation if you don't want to. You can use this software to reframe to more conventional shots. If you just want to pan around your environment, this is the perfect software to do it. So we're going to do that by pressing the keyframe button again. You can stay in fisheye mode this time, that's perfectly fine. And just like before, we can use our mouse wheel to zoom in. So I'm going to start on this perspective, my keyframe set. This time I'm going to move the perspective with me running around the camera. So I just simply drag my image, set a keyframe, and I keep doing it. Keep repeating, make sure I'm in the middle each time, new keyframe. All the way around, and when we watch this back, take a look at this. How good is that? One cool update in this version of Studio is you can now save your projects. So if I go File, Save, next time I open up this file, these keyframes are going to appear in the timeline just as they are now. Now it's time to export, so we'll go File, Export, and now we choose our resolution. Depending on how big you want your final video to be, you can enter it in manually. So I want this to be 3840 by 2160 because I want to add it into a 4K 16 by 9 timeline. If the project you're working with is only HD, then put 1920 by 1080. You can choose your bitrate, and at the very least I'd put 30, but if you have space on your hard drive, I'd go up to 100 at least, because this means your file is going to play back with the maximum amount of detail and quality possible. Now give your file a name, and hit that big old export button. All right, that's it. That's the workflow for reframing 360 videos, but you might be wanting to reframe a 360 photo. How do you do that? Well, you can't yet do that in this software, but I know a sneaky little workaround that I'm going to show you right now. It's quite simple, really. What we're going to do is open up our editing software. You may use Premiere, Final Cut, or something else. We're going to start a new project and import the 360 photo that we want to reframe. Make sure the timeline resolution is the exact same as the resolution as your 360 photo. Next, we're going to drag out the length of the photo to however long you want your animation to be. In this example, I'm going to drag it to 30 seconds. Now that's it, I'm going to export that now, and you'll want to make sure you're exporting again at the exact same dimensions of the original 360 photo, so we have maximum resolution later on to reframe. So now we've turned this equirectangular photo into an equirectangular video file, and now we simply import it and reframe in Insta360 Studio just like we did before. And voila, we have an awesome looking 360 photo reframed at high resolution. I've got to say, this software is really incredible. They could easily be charging money for this because the value it gives you as a 360 photographer or video creator is incredible. It allows you to create professional 360 animations in minutes on your computer, and you get that high resolution, so it looks super professional and really helps you get the most out of your camera. If you want to learn more about the entire 360 video workflow, I have a video course called A Beginner's Guide to 360 Video you'll definitely want to check out, because it teaches you my entire workflow from beginning to end and how to get the most professional result possible with your 360 camera when shooting 360 video. Link, you know where it is. Well, that's it from me. Be sure to hit that subscribe button for more awesome 360 photo and video tutorials coming very soon. And now it's time for me to go get some exercise. I'll see you in the next one.